"Oh, let Jinjur be the Queen!" exclaimed Tip, ready to cry. "I want to stay a boy, and travel with the Scarecrow and the Tin Woodman and the Woggle Bug and Jack, yes, and my friend the Sawhorse, and the Gump. I don't want to be a girl."
"Never mind, old chap," said the Tin Woodman soothingly. "It don't hurt to be a girl, I'm told, and we will all remain your faithful friends just the same. And to be honest with you, I've always considered girls nicer than boys."
"They're just as nice anyway," added the Scarecrow, patting Tip affectionately upon the head.
"And they are equally good students,"
proclaimed the Wogglebug.
"I should like to become your tutor when you are transformed into a girl again."
"But see here," said Jack Pumpkinhead with a gasp,
"if you become a girl, you can't be my dear father anymore."
"No," answered Tip, laughing in spite of his anxiety, "and I shall not be sorry to escape the relationship." Then he added, hesitatingly, as he turned to Glinda, "I might try it for a while, just to see how it seems, you know. But if I don't like being a girl, you must promise to change me into a boy again."
"Really," said the sorceress, "that is beyond my magic. I never deal in transformations, for they are not honest, and no respectable sorceress likes to make things appear to be what they are not. Only unscrupulous witches use the art. Therefore I must ask Mombi to effect your release from her charm and restore you to your proper form. It will be the last opportunity she will have to practice magic." Now that the truth about Princess Ozma had been discovered, Mombi did not care what became of Tip, but she feared Glinda's anger, and the boy generously promised to provide for Mombi in her old age if he became the ruler of the Emerald City. So the witch consented to effect the transformation, and preparations for the event were at once made. Glinda ordered her own royal couch to be placed in the center of the tent. It was piled high with cushions and covered with rose-colored silk, and from a golden railing above hung many folds of pink gossamer, completely concealing the interior of the couch.